Brush up, brush up, brush up, brush up, brush up, brush up. Wow.
It is 7:30 in the morning. I'm heading to the gym. This is how dark it is still. Right, good morning. It is still dark out. We said goodbye to James this morning before he went to the hospital because he's getting his tonsils out. This kid has the biggest tonsils I've ever seen in my life. Like, they take up his whole throat. It's crazy. Anyways, so I got up early around 6-ish just so I could, you know, see him off. And then I had some breakfast. I had cereal and a banana because I'm going to the gym. And if I was just going to Pilates, I would just have a banana before. But I'm going early so I can go on the treadmill, and I plan on, you know, doing stuff, and I need fuel for that stuff. So I had breakfast. Grandy and Poppy are going to take Lily into school because I'll be at the gym until like 10-ish. I was gonna say something and I completely forgot. Oh, I'm going to Talkeetna today. So I got a pack for that. I'm staying the night. That's all. Here's my energy for the day. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. Pilates was way harder this time. It was perfect. Like, it was so good. I finally feel like I can breathe again. I only coughed a couple times during the class, and I was trying to like stifle it because I didn't want people to like judge me. I don't know. But it was really good. I feel really good. It was hard. I was schwitzing quite a bit. And the lady next to me complimented me. Her name is Lois. I am now gonna go home and do some laundry and pack and then be on my merry way. Yep. Wait, I had something. Also, why does my hat look? I feel like if I put it like this, it looks okay, but like I can't see enough. Anyways, yesterday was like, I meant to vlog it, but I was just like caught up in the moment. But so, yesterday I just had a moment, and it was just really cool where I just felt like part of the family and not like the nanny, you know? Like, it was last night when someone got a cup stuck in the garbage disposal, and Jaisal brought up freaking plunger trying to get it out, and we were just like making fun of each other, and it was just like, you know, family banter. And I kind of had this moment where I was like, whoa, like I'm just like, it felt like I was with my family, you know, like making fun of each other, like having little jokes and just like recording each other looking silly. And it was just like, I don't know, it was such a cool moment. And I've just been so lucky with this family. Like, holy moly, we get along so well. I love these kids. I love these parents. Like, when they're looking for a new house, because they're moving, actually to New Hampshire, which is kind of funny. Anyways, I told them, I was like, yeah, you should probably get a house with like a pool house or like, you know, an in-law apartment so that, you know, I have somewhere to be. And they were like, yeah, should. Like, honestly, I would keep living with them. If I had like a separate space, I would rent from them. I don't know. I know it's only been a couple months, month and a half, but it just feels like it's working so well, and I feel so blessed. It is a charmed life I'm living. Anyways, that's all I wanted to say. All right, I'm on the road. For some reason, Google Maps is like doing like the 3D view, like the satellite view, and I don't know how to change it, and I don't know why it did that. I did my hair because like I didn't want to shower twice today, and honestly part of me was like, do I even want to shower tonight? And I'm like, yeah, that's gonna be gross if I don't shower tonight. So I guess I'll shower tonight. Anyways, I look cute, and I'm on my way to Talkeetna, and I'm not gonna have to stop for gas, I don't think, because my range says 212 miles and I have like 112 miles to drive. So I'll just stop on the way back, which might be more expensive, but whatever. As I was leaving, they were trying to tell me about this like gift shop or whatever on the way. And I was like, listen, I appreciate that you're trying to give me tips, but I really don't need to be spending more money right now. Like, I have bought so much stuff already. And as I walked out of my room, Jason goes, do you have enough money? And I was like, yes, dad. Thanks. This is funny. I'm just talking because I like to listen to myself and I like to look at myself and I'm just so self-centered and I'm so important. House that somebody built a bunch of little cabins on top of it, and you can see it from the road, and I thought, oh great, I'll get to take a picture of it. But then I drove by and it disappeared. I don't know how to get to it, so it must be like in somewhere, and I feel weird about driving in someone's driveway, but yeah, that was really cool. I've been seeing Denali pretty much like the whole time, so that's pretty cool too. I am tired and I just want to get there. I woke up early today. I didn't take a nap yet, so maybe I'll get there, take a nap, walk around. I don't know. I don't know if it's gonna rain. I also didn't bring my winter coat, which I thought would be okay, and now I feel like I'm making a choice. My brother's girlfriend Maggie texted me and said that she finished Where the Crawdads Sing, which I recommended. I gave her my copy, lent her my copy, did not give, lent. And she was like, do you have any other recommendations or books that I could borrow? And I was like, you know, like when someone actually takes the advice that you give them, it made me feel so good. So that was really nice. So I'm gonna think. I have to think on that one. Don't ask me why. So now I'm jamming to Billy. I feel like I have, I don't know, half hour left, maybe? I haven't stopped at all. I'm surprised I haven't had to pee. I might be behind on my wall. I might not hit a gallon today. That's all right. All right, I've got to speed up so I don't get stuck behind this tractor. Excuse me, that burp tasted good. Was that TMI? I don't know. Wow, it's so freaking pretty here. Like, how is this my life? Now all I need is a little Hallmark romance. Just kidding. I don't need that. It would be nice. I could find a nice Jewish boy here. So far, I've scared them all off. Literally every Jewish guy I've matched with on Bumble, like, has ghosted me. Not, like, ghosted, like, we weren't, like, talking, like, enough to be, like, ghosting, but, like, has stopped answering me. And I'm like, did I scare you? One of them, this guy was like, yeah, I'm here. He was Jewish. He was like, yeah, I'm here through election day, whatever, for work. And he's like, do you have any recommendations of things I should see while I'm here in Anchorage? And I said, me? And he never responded. He did not match me, but he never responded. And I was like, come on, that was funny. I thought it was funny. Clearly he didn't, and it's fine. He saw himself out, but I was like, I don't know what I'm doing wrong. It's fine. I might have to settle for someone who's not Jewish while I'm here. Because I'm not lonely, but like to have some of that. It's just hard because like the last three guys in a row that I was dating as like going on dates with, they were all Jewish. This is really hard. It's so hard. I just want to find someone Jewish. Like that, it's just so hard to find that apparently. I don't know. My sister found a Jewish boy. Well, Jew-ish, emphasis on the ish. I don't know. there's my rant. If you're a nice Jewish boy and you're willing to relocate to New England, call me. I'm basically on the road to go, and I stopped here because it said gift shop, and why not? Frostbound Home and Gift. Closed? Are you kidding me? Really? It said open. All right, well, I guess I'm not going here. None. So I just got a message from the Airbnb host, and he said that he had to move me to a bigger cabin because the one that he was gonna have me in had a maintenance issue. So let's go check it out. I'm excited. Okay, so I'm gonna give you a little tour of this place. It is so cute. I'm starting upstairs because I'm already up here. Actually, you know what? No, I'll start downstairs. Yeah, why not? Dum, 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 dum. Why don't I get my stuff and then... where'd I put my keys? Ah! So here's the outside. The whole thing. Let's go in. That's my bedroom. Right there. There's me. So you walk in, right? I'm so excited that there's an upstairs. That's just, I don't know why it's really exciting to me. Here's an area. So I put my backpack, my hiking boots, coats. Then there's two big couches. Let's test it out. All right, first couch. Oh, yeah. Wow, I wish I was staying here for 2 days. This is so comfy. Oh man, there's like puzzles and stuff and bingo. Man, I'm gonna have a really good time tonight. Second couch. Oh yeah. Oh baby. And then we've got futon. This looks all right. It's pretty comfy. And then this chair. Let's try out all the chairs. Oh yeah. Oh baby. That might be my favorite chair. Okay. Let's keep going. So this is the whole living area. Then we have the kitchen. It's got an oven, 4 burners. It's got all this stuff. You know, it's got that and that. Little hot chocolate. How cute. And then the fridge, which is pristine. Absolutely pristine. Let's look, what's up here? Okay, cups and stuff. I'm gonna guess this one's plates. Maple syrup, nice. Sugar-free maple syrup, no, don't want that. I can't reach that one. Let's see, freezer, ice thingy. In here, there's a vacuum and some extra chairs. No, I think I have enough for myself. Here's the bedroom, number one. Got some hooks, very nice. I've already got my sewing machine there. Let's try out the bed. Okay. Oh, she is comfy. I like this. Normally, I don't like to be on the first floor when I am staying by myself as a female, but I think it's gonna be warmer if I stay down here than upstairs. Okay, let's go upstairs. So we've got the stairs, which I'm so excited about. And we've got 2 rooms. So we've got this room in here. Nice. Let's try these beds. Not as comfy as the other one. Let's try this one. Oh, this one's softer, but still not as comfy as the one downstairs. How about the chair? I'm gonna try out the chair. Did not love that. And then we have closet with another vacuum. Hey, cool. And then we've got this other room. We've got chair and 2 beds. I don't know where the light switch is. Is it this one? Aha, there we go. That's better. Now to try out all the furniture. Pretty comfy one. This bed. It's all right. I wouldn't hate it if I had to sleep in it. Same thing with this one. Was that the Wi-Fi? Oh no, it's a charger. This place is nice, dude. Okay, that's that. I'm gonna close these doors so that the heat stays down there. Maybe I'll leave one light on so people think that it's not just me here. All right, well, now that I've spent an hour updating people about where I am, I'm gonna go explore and see what's up. I'm gonna have another snack though. What do I want? What do I want? If you like to dance with tomatoes. I thought this was the apple one. It's coconut. It's okay. It's not my fave. Okay. It feels weird being here out of season. It's so quiet. But I'm literally downtown. Like, there's downtown. There's my cabin. It's so quiet. I just picked up some peony salt because I'm intrigued. So. It's weird, I feel like I have the whole place to myself, but I also feel like I need to be quiet. So I was just walking along the road and this place smelled so good and I was like, maybe I'll come back here for lunch tomorrow because I have a salad for dinner. But then they're closed tomorrow and I was like, I'm just gonna go. So I got fish and chips and I went and I was like, oh, can I get some ketchup? And hold on, I'm dropping everything. I also got two Iditarod books. I was like, oh, can I get some ketchup? And he goes, okay, so that's gonna be $1.40 each packet. And I was like, are you serious? And he was like, no, I'm totally kidding. I was like, you know what? Being in Alaska, wouldn't be surprised. Would not be surprised. So I'm gonna go back and enjoy this in my cabin. And then tomorrow morning, walk around some more. Well, I just finished Harry Potter. I have about 500 more steps to get to 10,000. And yeah, I'm just gonna go take a shower. What was I gonna say? Oh, I FaceTimed Lillian because Cynthia texted me and kept saying that Lillian kept asking where I was. And so I called her and she was looking at me like this the whole time on the phone. Like doing her little face and I was like, stop it. I miss her. I'm like, where's my Lillian? So it was really funny because Cynthia was like, yeah, she wouldn't call her parents or talk to James, but she'll talk to you for 10 minutes. Anyways, after like the fourth time she asked me what I was doing, and I kept answering the same thing. I was like, okay, bye, Lillian. But it was really cute. So yeah, it's been dark already for a few hours. It's only 8, so, and it's not gonna get light until like 9. So I'm gonna go watch some more Netflix, yeah.